The first thing we want to understand is how can we get the mass of those spinning towels, the towels that were twirling around over our head, how can we get their mass from a graph? Well, we've been using this equation, F equals mv squared over r, the centripetal force needed to keep something moving in a circular path, is equal to its mass times the square of the speed divided by the radius. We also know the equation of a line, y equals mx plus b. Y is whatever we're graphing on the y-axis. X is whatever we're graphing on the x-axis. M is the slope of the line, and b is the y-intercept. I think I need to point out, both of these equations have m's in them, and that can be a little confusing because those m's are very different. For some reason, we always use m in the equation for a line, y equals mx plus b, and that m stands for the slope of the line. But in our centripetal force equation, F equals mv squared over r, that m is the mass of whatever is spinning around in a circle. So try not to get confused by that. As you become familiar with working with equations, this becomes easier and easier. We want our equation, F equals mv squared over r, to look like this equation of a line, y equals mx plus b. And it's pretty close now. I'm just going to move the r from under the v squared to under the m. It's the same exact equation. The big difference here is that y is equal to mx and f is equal to something times v squared. But if I treat v squared as one quantity, instead of thinking of it as v and squaring it, I just think of it as v squared and plot v squared on the x-axis, then this takes the shape of the equation y equals mx plus b. If I plot force on the y-axis and I plot v squared on the x-axis, then the slope of that line should be the mass of my towels divided by the radius.